So I'm leaving the UPS terminal in Pontiac, Michigan right now. They've got a customer service center here, a little drop-off with two little computers. You type in all your information, it prints out a little barcode, you take it up to the counter, and then you pay. And of course, they've got the sign on the door. You know, you can't enter here without a mask. It's just handwritten sign. And then when you get in there, they've got the hanging plexiglass shields in front of the two registers they have there. They never have two people in there working. They've always got one angry employee working in there. I went in and I'm typing my information in the computer, sending something, sending a package to a friend, and wanted to use UPS this time, and thought I'd also check it out, just see how it was there. And when I turned around and went up to the register, the guy said, "Sir, you have to put your mask on." And I said, "Are you serious?" And he goes, "Yeah, I'm breathing in your air right now." I said, "Really? Through this plexiglass shield and the mask that you're wearing?" He goes, "Sir, could you just put your mask on? It's a requirement." And I said, "I don't want to." And he says, "Well, I have to breathe your air, and I've already gotten this, and trust me, you don't want this." I wanted to tell him, "You look fine to me," because he was standing tall, and, you know, all that bitterness must keep him healthy. But I pulled up my my keffiyeh. I've got a keffiyeh that I wear around my neck, and I've got it just in case I'm somewhere where I absolutely have to do necessary business, and I have to wear a mask. And so far, this is only the second place that has ever told me to put on a mask. The first place, I pulled this thing up over my face for 60 seconds before I said, "I can't deal with this," and walked out. It wasn't that important to me. I had principles to stand on. But here I was kind of committed. I wanted to ship this package. So I decided, hey, I'll just deal with it. But the mask slipped off my face. It slipped off my nose, then covered my mouth. Then it slipped off my mouth, went right back around my neck. I guess I got it tied a little tight. And one of the UPS employees in uniform came walking in, no mask, no nothing, and he said, "You can't come through here without a mask." So the guy went back out to his car to get a mask. And then another customer came in behind me. He was wearing the face mask, and he was keeping his distance from me. Look, here's the deal. They're putting up all of these shields that are pointless. People are wearing masks incorrectly, and for the general public to be wearing a mask, that's not the way they work, okay? That's not the way they're meant to work. And in addition to that, we're exercising social distancing, reduced hours. You know what's funny is he took my driver's license, which I touched with my bare hands. He took my credit card, which I touched with my bare hands. He handed me an ink pen that has probably been passed back and forth between him and other customers all day long, and I touched it with my bare hands. And he took it back from me. And he didn't have gloves on at all. At all. So tell me, if I have this germ on my fingertips and he just touched three things that I touched, oh, and the box, so that's four things, and the label, that's five, and then after I leave, he decides to rub his eyes, what's the point of the mask? You people are just stupid. I'm not even going to say you look stupid anymore. I'm just going to call you stupid. I see people all the time. They pull their mask down to talk on the cell phone. They pull their mask down to have a conversation with somebody. They put their mask over their mouth, not their nose, because they're so sick that they can't deal with the fact they can't breathe through the damn thing. I keep seeing people pull it off to the side of their face. I still don't understand that. And is that kind of like me wearing a keffiyeh around my neck? I've got it just in case I need it, but I'm just going to leave it over there? I don't know. But all this is a bunch of crap. And I don't believe the numbers. I just don't believe 1.5 million Americans have gotten this or died from it or whatever the heck it is. You know, they're just going to change the number to suit their purpose. I'm okay at this point getting this damn flu and laying in bed for a couple days sick. Just to prove a point that it's the flu. We need to get America back to work. And the sad thing is, there are people like me who work at factories. We make a decent living. We can support our families. And our money trickles back into the economy and is the backbone of the American economy. And if people are not buying durable goods, they can't really justify our jobs. I do believe that if the economy doesn't pick up sooner than later, we're going to be in a lot bigger trouble than just a short recession. This is going to be a mess. And your mask and your plexiglass shield and your hand sanitizer and your social distancing and your gloves and your reduced capacity is not going to save you, me, or the economy. And the economy is what puts food in the stomachs of our families. So screw you, screw your mask, UPS, you people suck.